Yeah, I'm Matthew Kingpin. I am a silly individual, and as such, I occasionally find myself to be a connoisseur of the whimsical and goofy, and I perhaps have no better example of an artist that embraces the full extent of creative whimsy than Value Select, a skit comedy slash novelty track YouTuber slash songwriter whom I've been following for quite some time now, and have time and time again been unfailingly amused by. I wanted to talk about one of their latest mastercrafts, entitled American Summer, a bit of a compilation album they put out that essentially acted as a remaster slash director's cut of some of their best works over the last year or so, to show my appreciation for what they do and get some of my many thoughts about their work that I've been stockpiling for a while now out onto the page and perhaps even introduce someone else to Max Menner's morphing of the mundane into majestic mirth pop. I'll be going over every track in the album. Some songs will be quickly summated, and others I'll say a little more on. So I'm just gonna go right down the list and get right into talking about the discography. Humble beginnings await us in the musical recounting of the awkward situation one may find themselves subjected to when walking down a narrow path and encountering an unplanned social interaction with a street stranger. I love the feeling of social anxiety this track highlights, and how neither participant wants to let the other person have the final word to the point of overextending the conversation, and indeed the song itself, in a good way, far past the original intended purpose, which was to acknowledge and move on as quickly as possible. A solid introduction.
A house party, you say? In the suburbs? This eve shall be legendary.
There was a reason for the perilous venture into the yonder land of the outdoors, and that was to attend a marvelous party held by the one and only Lord Gwendemir. Except, psych! No entry was permitted for the protagonist of this journey, but opportunity still struck the distraught Mr. Renner, as he simply could fall back onto a different social opportunity, one without the pizzazz and regal flair of the manor's offerings, to be fair, but with the comparatively honest nightly itinerary of a realistic party. This track speaks onto the reality of adult get-togethers in most situations, in that they tend to be more awkward and slapdash than the word party oftentimes is connotated with. It's a lovely track, a highlight of it being the swapping out of the slaughtering of an off-tune acoustic guitar player with a dorky dance break, complete with a mid-break checking of footwear for lace tie et ness, staying perfectly in theme with the track's pure honesty. After any awkward adult party, though, one must find themselves venturing back home. Our protagonist, unfortunately freshly relinquished of their automobile, though I feel that Lord Gwendemir probably would prove to be quite the bad driver, tailgating at about 98, if I had to venture a guess, eventually arrives back at his humble abode, a pertinent hunger arising in them from the multi-mile journey. But alas, the fridge was empty before they left. Why would its contents have changed apropos of nothing? A nothing fridge, it certainly still is, a track that excellently conveys the absurdity in hoping that the cold box of prior disappointment will have somehow decided to have spontaneously conjured up a different offering, when we all know in reality that is simply never the case. The extension adding a cooking interlude and ample time to enjoy the groovy bassline and mirthy beat is a welcome addition to an already fun track. I have nothing bad to say about this offering. Despite the grim outlook of a mostly empty food receptacle, our protagonist is nevertheless able to prepare a meal and transition to the widely cherished art of chow and channel chasing. YouTube channel chasing, that is. However, he finds that his favorite YouTuber has been caught up within a drama-laden dropping of their facade of innocence, and has been forced into making a YouTuber apology. An already complete feeling track in its original form, this extended rendition continues on from the albeit somewhat abrupt ending from the original, and augments the apologetic offerings with a well-produced guitar solo and a slight reframing of the track as somewhat of a reflective piece on the nature of dogpiling onto an exposed person of interest as potentially more of a projection than most will ever be comfortable admitting to. A welcome addition to the tracklist, and I ain't sorry for saying so. Sufficiently satiated and slightly slumber-induced, our protagonist ventures away from the online realm of drama and doom scrolls, but the universe has different plans. They are suddenly greeted by a visage of an entirely different form of betrayal. A friend, who previously proclaimed their absence and unavailability from the online realm, is playing one such network game sans our protagonist's company. How can one begin to build virtual camaraderie when you're online without me? This track's excellent lyricism is its main highlight, with the groove-laden spoken words of an odyssey of online friendship failing, proving to be exceptionally catchy, memorable, and relatable. Your free time does belong exclusively to me, don't you know? That's why you should subscribe. Ah, you've stepped outside after such a cringe-laden self-promotion by myself. I can understand the sentiment entirely. Our protagonist's journey similarly sees them venturing out for a moment's pause and reflection, the previous minute's learnings of broken promises driving them to do so. A clear sky hangs above, but not for long, as a vaporizer soon fills the air with a cherry-scented drowning of inner turmoil, such as the way of the Ballad Vapist. An enjoyably chill recounting of how some choose to escape from the sound of their much-needed thoughts with a puff of acrid, artificially flavored smoke, or some other similarly unhealthy coping mechanism. Something surely upsetting to some, though probably not for too long if they're of the targeted group, if you catch my drift.
For example.
Speaking of drift, the protagonist finds themselves attempting to do so, off to the realm of dreams, but must first make a pit stop of unnecessary 3 a.m. bedtime thoughts as they find themselves pondering onto the legacy of the creator of the foldable chair. It's a funny and, well, fun, little diversion, a nugget of pure chaotic thought not atypical of the type of thing one might conjure up in a tired nighttime daze. There's not too much new here from the original track, but it works well as a goofy transition onto the next track. Eventually, the exhaustion overtakes our protagonist as he finds himself slipping away and arriving into the magical and infinite possibility-laden world of dreams. Their first course of action, of course, is to make a utopian society that absolutely, 100%, will work this time. Trust him. Genius. Wow, some might say to that plan. This track is probably my third favorite out of the whole selection on offer. It's infinitely replayable and engineered to be an earworm melody, and exceptionally well-performed vocals give a worldview that absolutely deserves to be tried again, for sure, trust us, an upbeat and fantastic musical score. Something I really love about this extension, though, is the morose break at the end of the track after the main melody fades following everyone partying a little too hard. It comes across to me as just that, a party that is over, its guests all scattered, the silence deafening and somber nature of being alone proving to be almost overwhelmingly melancholic. It's something that gets me feeling uneasy and pensive every time the fade-out occurs. But thankfully, this was all just a dream! We awaken to find our protagonist mourning the loss of the potential society of what their dream world theorized, but also angry at the world for what it could have been if only they weren't given such an impossible standard to uphold. For you see, our protagonist was/is a gifted kid. This track is a blistering condemnation of the concept, a calling out of those who use that former designation as a way to justify their lack of success. Something I wanted to mention in specific, it's a really small section of the track, but I exceptionally enjoy the part where the I in I Could Have Gone Pro gets repeated to the beat. It makes my ADHD brain go zoom. This extension, much in the same vein as YouTuber Apology, adds an exceptionally tasty guitar solo performance to round out the unyielding verbal beatdown. And also, ouch. I too was a gifted kid, and the expectations were both crushing in an academic sense and in a psychological sense. But this track, while harsh, is fair. However, I don't have any intention of letting my life go to complete waste without making something of my existence before I go. The protagonists themselves comes to a similar conclusion, vowing to remake their bed of life and choosing to live in the world of reality instead of hiding behind excuses, fantasies, and half-truths. Although the first truth they admit is, well, admittedly a bit of a petty one, though it is quite relatable. They have, in fact, been looking at themselves in the Zoom call. It's a fun little tune, with an extension that garnishes the already catchy melody with a choir section and a charming orchestral flair towards the conclusion of the piece. This said orchestra seamlessly transitions into the protagonist deciding to act upon their newfound vow to live their life, and with haste, he departs on a grand off-screen adventure. From this point on, the narrative through line of the album dissipates, though the quality of the tracks does no such thing, thankfully. Similarly, my, albeit somewhat forced, integration of the titles of each track into my pun-laden script writing will also take a backseat, as I desire nothing more than for this video's content to be truly magical, as if it were a ballad, a magician's ballad, if you will. Okay, my aggressive trolling aside, Magician's Ballad was already an exceptionally well-written and performed nugget of sublime silliness. I mean, that vocal line where Mr. Renner belts out, "Now he's an American hero of the USA," is absolute musical kino. But the addition of a piano solo at the end of the track pushes the whole package into maximum overdrive, making this magic-oriented track leave me spellbound every time I hear it. Speaking of wizardry, the next track finds us attempting to follow in the footsteps of the master of illusions and trickery that came before us in an enchanting lyrical showcasing of the existential dread and melancholy of being caught between eras. And a lyrical showcasing it indeed is, with line after line of absolutely heartfelt, relatable, and humorous longings for time periods of either the past or the future, experiences either lost forever to time or simply too far out of reach of our limited lifespans. I especially adore the delivery of the "just a family-owned and operated dream machine with a theme" line, the soaring high notes really putting a nice bow on top to conclude the lyrical section. The extension augments the standard piano backing track into a full orchestral showcase that gives the masterfully crafted lyricism an accompaniment that can truly complement its level of magnificence. But after such a bombastic orchestral flair, there should be a complimentary slower piece to balance out the overall mood of the album, a quarantining of energy, one even might say. Quarantine Love Song is a light-hearted little tidbit of trying to stay sane and without misery in the face of being trapped indoors and away from the world outside. I must admit, there have been many a time in my own life where I felt more affection towards an inanimate object than I did for any actual human being, and the love shown towards the oscillating fan of Quarantine Love Song is hence very relatable. The extension of this track adds an entire new verse and set of lyrics alongside allowing the quaint backing piano track to bleed over the beginning and end of the vocals so that we the viewer might appreciate it more thoroughly. But as the piano of the quarantine fades and the great outdoors are once again made available to venture forth into, a limerick of peak whimsy starts to form out of the aether of the outside's offerings. This limerick's chief causation being the many often esoteric signs one frequently encounters adorning the many urbanized city streets and roads, their writings something I am unable to mime out through words alone. Mime Signs is an absolute gem of a track, seamlessly recounting the writings of many different signposts, ranging from mundane standard instructions to outright silly cautionary scribblings. It's a piece that shows how much even what most consider to be unassuming and unworthy of attention or additional thought can be made into something fun and magical with enough childlike imagination and mischievousness. To demonstrate this point, by the end of the song, the track has morphed into a warning about the imminent takeover of the mimes, and the protagonist is taken away by his day-dreamt-up adversary. A silly and greatly enjoyable bit of fun lyricism. The extension adds a musical foreword and afterword to the track that exemplifies the already supremely light-hearted, whimsical nature of its offerings, and these instrumentals make me smile every time I listen to them. This track is the principal example of the overall theme of this album, the joy that can be found in the mundane, as I mentioned in the title of this video. However, much as I get a kick out of Mime Signs, it's time to move on to the next piece. If only I could exist in that maximum of enjoyment at all times. It's my fantasy, after all. Some might even call it a male fantasy. It's a male fantasy! This track is a goofy experience about the age-old meme of what do men really want, and Mr. Renner's answer to this question is what makes up the offerings of this piece. It's a high-energy track that provides the oftentimes greatly desired venture into the minds of an oftentimes greatly confusing people group. An extra set of lyrics and standard 80s-style fade-out are adorned to the end of the track for extension purposes this time, and those additions are both welcomed and appreciated. After all this typing, writing, singing, manufactured fear about the imminent invasion of the shadow government of mimes, one may find themselves a bit beleaguered and wanting to return home, which in the case of the protagonist is their apartment complex. And indeed, this track goes into the exact appeal, or lack thereof, such a place can offer, complete with a witty set of lyrics and a bodacious accompaniment track, the extension even going the extra mile to add content to both the beginning and end of the original piece. It's not complex, but it is satisfactory. Give me my money. And such, like an unwanted thought being fired out of the subconscious memory, a reminder of an unpleasant occurrence is, once again, resurfaced through presumably a notification on a cellular phone. The unpleasant occurrence of lending out a pittance of funds that still has not been properly reciprocated by the borrower. While all of the music in this album can easily be described as having a lyrical highlight, this track in particular has quite the seamless harmony between its backing musical score and the vocal performance. A level of catchiness that is extremely easy to find oneself getting into the groove of. The extension, while simple, does permit this groovy backing track to persist for just a little bit longer, to allow us, the listener, the chance to enjoy it for just a little bit longer. But like all good things, this aforementioned backing track too finds its end. And similarly, the album itself comes to a close. But not before one last surprise musical hurrah in the form of Never Loved, a fitting track to be placed at the end of American Summer's musical relationship with us, the listener. Never Loved is an acoustic recounting of an all-too-relatable feeling of having a love go sour, a relationship wither away, and the potential disparaging of those who are involved in it, if one does not cope well or amicably with a companionship's cessation. This remix is possibly the most stylistically divergent from the original track, with the first iteration of the piece giving a very morose and uncomfortable showcasing of a death-spiraling demonization of the other party, and this new version giving a starkly contrasting, upbeat, and almost folk-songy toxic positive activity-esque flair to the situation. As a huge fan of the original version, I have to say that I absolutely adore this more recent edition of the prior track, and I find it to be an exceptionally great send-off to this Mastercraft album. I wouldn't change a thing about either it or the album it provides a close to. And with that, that is the entirety of American Summer. That's about all I have to say for this production. Or rather, I should say, I've run out of things to say! I've listened to this compilation of extended musical shorts quite a number of repeats in the brief window of time it's been available for viewing, and I have found new things to love about it almost every single time I've chosen to revisit The American Summer. I've been wanting to talk about it with someone, anyone, for a little while now, so I figured since my friends aren't the type to enjoy its offerings, I'd go ahead and document all my many thoughts about the tracklist here on my channel. If you've made it to the end of this video, might I say you, sir, slash ma'am, slash other, are a legend. A legend worthy of Lord Windermere's personal approval, I might even go so far as to say. And in the unlikely scenario that my words reach Mr. Renner's ears as well, I just wanted to say thank you for continuing to make musical works of art. They're small pockets of happiness and whimsy in a world that is often dreary and miserable, and I cannot express my appreciation for what you do enough through words alone. Keep doing what you're doing, King. Anyways, for those of you who wish to stay informed of my new productions, I have a Discord server where I post updates about my new videos every time I make one. Please consider joining it if you wish to know when I post. YouTube is quite unpredictable about letting people know when I do so. Other than that, the usual methods of helping the channel out and the algorithm are always appreciated if you wish to do them. Regardless, burn your dread and have a peaceful night. Go into the future, and I'll meet you there.
Nice. Ooh, you know where he is. Oh! Wah. Fire.
I thought I was a free kill. A free dub.
These guys don't have a chance in hell.